In this presentation, we are going to look at data compression and, in particular, how to compute efficiency, the efficiency of a code type. Now, it depends on two things: entropy and code length. So they are going to be two parts of this calculation. So suppose we have this alphabet here, and it's comprised of six symbols. And the code there is at the end. So the symbol A is encoded as 00, the symbol B is encoded as 01. Now what we want to do is compute the efficiency for this code. So how do we go about it? So this is the symbol for efficiency, and that's the Greek letter eta or eta, and it's the entropy divided by the expected code length, or the average code length for the source, the symbol source. So what we have to do is compute E of L. I'm going to start with E of L, the expected code length, just because it's a simpler calculation. But also we're going to do the code entropy. So first off, what we have to do is compute the code length. So for each symbol, the probability of that symbol times the length of the code for that symbol. So let's have a look at it there. So let's bring up our example again. So our symbol A, the probability of it is 0.3, 0.25, so on. So the code for A is 00, that is length 2. Code for B, also length 2, 2, 3, 4, and 4. Okay? So the next part of the calculation is multiply the code length by the probability. So essentially what we have to do is multiply everything in one row by everything in the other row and column, sorry. So we have to multiply 0.3 by 2, that's 0.6. 0.25 by 2, that's 0.5. Let's see now, 0.4. 0.12 times 3, that's 0.36. 0.08 by 4, that's 0.32. And 0.05 by 4, that is 0.20. And at the end, what we have to do is add them all up. And we should get a value of 2.38. So, and that's bits. Okay. So that is the average code length. There it is there. There's actually a little typo there. That should be 0.6. Let me fix that. So that's how we would calculate it there. So again, multiply the value in this column by the corresponding value in this column. Okay, now the next part is we have to compute the entropy. And this is a very similar calculation, it's a little bit more complex. What we have to do is for each symbol, what we have to do is compute the probability of that symbol times the logarithm of that symbol. Just as one further thing, we have to use the negation symbol for that. So, minus the probability times the log to the base 2 of that probability, that computes the entropy. So let's do it out again here. In this case, what we have to do is a bit of calculator work. So the log to the base 2 of 0.3, let's write log to the base 2 of 0.3, that would work out as minus 1.74 log the base 2 of 0.25, that would work out to be minus 2, and so on. That's just calculator work there. Let's see what the rest of them there. 2.32 minus 3.06 minus 3.64 and minus 4.32. Okay, now what we have to do, just like we did for the average code length, what we have to do is multiply the probability times the log of that probability. So we have to multiply the corresponding numbers. Also, what we have to do is we have to remember to negate them, put a minus sign in front of them. So 0.3 times minus 1.74, and remember to change the sign to a positive number, 0.52. 0.25 times minus 2, and again change the sign, 0.50. The point of that is to make it a positive number. Make this plus 0.52, 0.50. 0.46, I'll just hurry up through it now. 0.37, 0.29, and 0.22. And again, what we have to do is we have to add up all of those numbers. And this would work out to be 2.36 bits per symbol. Okay, that's actually the notation. That's actually the units we're working in. We're not going to really use it in this calculation, but anyway, that is, we have the average code length and we have the efficiency of the entropy. So here is the calculation now. The entropy divided by the expected code length, 2.36 divided by 2.38, that works out to be 0.9915. So our efficiency is 99.15%. Very good efficiency. Okay, that ends our presentation.